Hello, Beaver County people. Just out for a little ride. It's around 10 to 9 or 8:50 a.m. Was a little bored, so I figured I'd go take a trip through New Brighton since, you know, the leaves are finally out. Trees are blooming. I know that sounded gay, but believe me, I'm 100% heterosexual. Not that I'm against gays. They can do whatever they want. You know, I don't want this to become controversial. You guys, they can do whatever they want. Just don't try and pull me into it. But I thought we'd take a ride down Main Street so you could see what the new Main Street looks like since they put in the new trees and they redid the road and they're redoing the library and library's gonna look good when they're finished with it. I'm actually surprised that they're renovating it. They've closed down a lot of the libraries in Beaver County, I was thinking. For those of you who have not been around for a while, Brickers closed down. I'm not sure if that was on my last New Brighton video or not, but I believe the owners of Kent Butcher Block bought it and is now called Main Street Market in Delhi. I hope I didn't run a red light just there. Here's a change. If, like I said, if my last video didn't show it, New Brighton now has the whole department down here instead of being three different departments, which is nice that they utilized that. Family video added Marco's Pizza. Who remembers Poyon's Market? You know, before Foodland and, well, we still had Economy here, but we had Poyon's Market. We used to come down here to get all of our fresh cut meats. Wolf Warren Auto still open and going strong. They added the fence on this hill. When we were kids, they didn't have a fence. It was either, you know, walk on the sidewalk or fall. But I'm glad they did that. If everybody remembers the corner girl. Thank you, Jack. Thank you, buddy. In Fifth Street Deli, they used to have the most awesomest, and I mean awesomest, subs, handmade subs at that, fresh cut meat. Not sure if they still do that or not, but they used to have the biggest penny candy variety in town. I still think they sell penny candy. If you're looking for penny candy, that's where you go. Now the fishies and the raspberries. This used to be Pizza Joe's back in the day and some kind of clothing store. And I remember, well, this here was Kent Butcher Blocks. It was Lemons back in the 80s. And this building here was the Oak Hill store. They had the very first video game that was animated. I believe it was Dragon Slayer, if I recall. Never could play that game. But that was actually the first like 50 cent game that was literally in New Brighton, if I remember right. right here on North 3rd Street. Wow, that's a nice big pothole. Take a ride past the... You're still not allowed to make a left-hand turn at the top of this, at the top of this hill. Here's Grove Cemetery. Tina Snediger, Vayner Place used to, was, grew up there. Let's see if I can get a better picture. Looks a lot different from when you guys were living there, guys. I grew up in this trailer park. Right here. Lot number 20. Denman Trailer Park. Jeff Anderson grew up there. But right back in the back there, right where that brown, right where the brown trailer is back there, that's where I grew up. It's a different trailer, but same lot. Tuscarora's right behind it. There's a garbage truck there, so we're gonna make it right here. Take the long way around. Well, I haven't been on this alley since I was actually a kid. If Carrie Bevington should remember that house. This used to be the castle house here. They knocked the walls down and made a garage out of it. But there used to be an archway to walk up through. You weren't able to see any of this yard because there was a wall. And this place right here used to be the store on the road on Grove Avenue. No, a little humbug store had, you know, just basic needs. Wasn't a big grocery store, but it was nice. Also had penny candy, but not that much. All these years and they've never widened this road. Off to my right here, that used to be Messick's Bar. I remember when Butchie passed away after making french fries. I guess he was cooking and fell asleep. Felt bad for him. Felt bad for the family. Alright, we're gonna make a right onto 10th Avenue. Sister, It's your turn, buddy. Caught right on video. Remember Brighton Superette when Bob owned it? Jeff Baldwin grew up here. Behind there is the Beaver Valley Bakery, if you remember it. There's my Uncle John's house. And if you recall, you missed a building that isn't there anymore, but that used to be the site where the old fire department used to be. Well, one of them. And if you haven't been here for a while, they tore down the old Catholic school where I used to go to CCD as a kid. And that concludes this tour. Hope you enjoyed it, ladies and gentlemen. Salute!